ब्लड इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कनेक्टिव टिश्यूज़ ऑफ आवर बॉडी एज इट इज़ ईजीली एक्सेसिबल. मोस्ट ऑफ द फिजियोलॉजिकल एक्सपेरिमेंट्स आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड ऑन ब्लड एंड टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म सच टू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स वेयर वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड सम फिजियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस. फॉर दिस फर्स्ट वी विल कलेक्ट अवर ब्लड एंड वी विल ट्राई टू मेजर द हीमोग्लोबिन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इन अवर ब्लड. इन द सेकेंड एक्सपेरिमेंट वी विल ट्राई टू टेक आउट द रेड ब्लड सेल्स ऑफ अवर बॉडी and then we will try to see the effect of ions on this red blood cells. Whenever we are feeling weakness or dizziness, our medical professional asks us to take hemoglobin estimation. Have you ever wondered why hemoglobin levels are so essential for our body? Today we are going to perform an experiment to learn that how we can estimate the blood hemoglobin levels. But before going into the experimental detail, let's first develop some basic understanding about this hemoglobin, that what is this hemoglobin, why it is so much essential, and what is its function in our body. Hemoglobin is the iron containing oxygen transport metalloprotein in the red blood cells of the vertebrates. Hemoglobin in the blood carries oxygen from the respiratory organ like lungs or gills to the rest of the body, where it releases the oxygen to burn nutrients, to provide energy, to power the functions of the organisms. And it also collects the resultant carbon dioxide to bring it back to the respiratory organs to be dispensed from the organism. In most vertebrates, the hemoglobin molecule is an assembly of four globular protein subunits. Each subunit is composed of a protein chain tightly associated with a known protein heme group. Each protein chain arranges into a set of alpha helix in such a fashion that it forms a pocket that strongly binds the heme group. This heme group consists of an ion held in the heterocyclic ring known as porphyrin ring. In adult humans, the most common hemoglobin type is a tetramer which contains four subunit proteins, and this is called as hemoglobin A, consisting of two alpha and two beta subunits. These subunits are covalently bound and the alpha subunit is 141 amino acid long, while the beta subunit is 146 amino acid long. And this hemoglobin is denoted as alpha 2 beta 2 chain. Hemoglobin deficiency can be caused either by decreased amount of hemoglobin molecules, as observed in the case of anemia, or also in the case of decreased ability of each molecule to bind oxygen. Hemoglobin concentration measurement is among the most commonly performed blood tests, usually as a part of complete blood tests. For example, it is typically tested before and after blood donations. The results are normally reported in gram per liter or gram per deciliter or mole per liter. In today's experiment, we are going to report the results in the unit of gram per deciliter. Normally, the hemoglobin levels in males are between 13.8 to 18 gram per deciliter. In the case of females, the hemoglobin levels are usually little low, that is 12.1 to 15.1 gram per deciliter. In case of children, the hemoglobin levels are between 11 to 16 gram per deciliter, while in case of pregnant females, the hemoglobin levels are between 11 to 12 gram per deciliter. Now, as we have developed sufficient information about the hemoglobin, let's move on to our experiment and understand that how we can estimate the hemoglobin levels in our blood. Before going into the experimental detail, let's first be clear with the aim of our experiment. Aim of this experiment is to find out the hemoglobin levels in the given blood sample. And for this, I'm going to use my own blood. Now, let's first understand the principle of this experiment. In this experiment, first we are taking our blood and then we are adding 0.1 normal HCl to it, because of which the hemoglobin is converted to acid hematin. This acid hematin is a brown colored compound, and then we will compare this acid hematin with the standard brown color and we will try to measure the hemoglobin levels. Now let's gather the material which we are going to need for this experiment. In this experiment, we are going to need 0.1 normal HCl. Apart from this, we are also going to need alcohol as a disinfecting agent. We are going to need some pricking needles. for pricking the fingers. We are going to need the hemoglobinometer. This hemoglobinometer consists of a comparator box, a special graduated diluting tube, a dropper for adding the water, and a small glass rod for stirring the solution. And this brown bottle is meant for storing the 0.1 normal HCl, and a pipette for the collection of blood drop. Now let's move on to our experiment and perform this experiment. For this, first we will collect 0.1 normal HCl in this bottle. Now take this graduated tube and fill 0.1 normal HCl up to the lowest mark. Now keep this dilution tube in the comparator box and get ready for collection of blood. Now let's collect the blood for this experiment. For this, we will take the cotton balls and we will dip it in the alcohol. After this, we will clean our finger with alcohol. Alcohol works as a germicidal agent and it kills all the bacteria. Once you had wiped your finger clearly with alcohol, we will allow it to air dry. Meanwhile, we will collect the pricking needle and the pipette for collection of blood. Before pricking your finger, you should hold the pipette well in your mouth. Now we will prick the finger and collect the blood. Immediately after collection of blood, transfer the blood into the dilution tube. Shake it well using the stirrer. When we are transferring our blood to the dilution tube, it reacts with 0.1 normal HCl and produces brown color. Now we will dilute this blood up to the extent that it produces similar brown color that is observed in the box. For this, we will take distilled water and we will add drop by drop to the dilution tube. After adding 2-3 drops, take a stirrer and mix these two solutions properly. After mixing properly, observe it again. Once the color matches perfectly, take out this dilution tube and observe the reading at lower meniscus. Here you can observe the reading at 14.5 mark, which indicates that the hemoglobin levels are 14.5 mg per deciliter. In this experiment, we can see that first, when we are adding the blood to the HCl, it is producing a dark brown color acid hematin. Then we are adding drop by drop water, because of which the color intensity is gradually reducing. When it is coming up to the light brown color, which is present in the comparable box, the standard color is produced. After this, we took out this dilution tube and then we had observed the standard color which is produced. That is indicating the presence of hemoglobin and the standard levels of hemoglobin in our blood. That is, in this experiment, we observed 14.5 mg per deciliter of hemoglobin in the given sample of blood. Hence, from today's experiment, we learned that the normal hemoglobin levels are between the range of 14 to 16, and my hemoglobin levels are 14.5, which is falling under normal category, which is indication of good health. And from this experiment, you also learned that how to estimate the hemoglobin levels in the given sample of blood, and I'm sure you can perform this experiment on your own also. This experiment is little tricky and you will have to be very fast. So there are certain precautions which you should take in order to perform this experiment without any error. You should be very precautious while collecting the blood. There are chances that air bubbles might come in, or if you are not fast enough, the blood might coagulate inside. You should also be very cautious while handling the glass rod and shaking this tube, as this tube is very fragile and it can break very easily. You will have to be very fast in taking the reading once the desired color is produced, because this compound acid hematin, its color will gradually keep deepening with the progression of time. We all had come across certain cases where the person is severely ill or he is having dehydration. In such cases, medical professionals advise him to give intravenous infusion of 0.9% saline. Have you ever wondered why 0.9% saline is given? Today we are going to perform an experiment to find out the answer to this question. Before going into the detail of this experiment, let's find out what are our red blood cells and what are the functions they perform and what are the effect of ions on these red blood cells. Red blood cells are the most common type of blood cells which are found in our blood. They perform the function of carrying oxygen from lungs to our tissue. These cells are rich in a protein called hemoglobin. This hemoglobin performs the function of carrying oxygen. As hemoglobin is red in color, our blood is also red in color. Our red blood cells are enucleated cells. That means they are not having any nucleus or any other type of cytoplasmic organelles. Because of lack of nucleus, they are very susceptible to changes in their environment. That is, whenever the ionic concentration is low in their environment, they tend to gain water and rupture. Apart from this, whenever the ionic concentration is high in their environment, they lose water and shrink in size. This is called as the phenomenon of osmosis. Today we are going to perform an experiment to see that what is the effect of ions on our red blood cells. That is, we will provide them with an environment which is hypertonic. That means the concentration of ions will be high in its environment. and we will also put it in the environment where the concentration of ions will be very low, that will be hypotonic environment. Now let's move on to this experiment and learn about this very basic phenomenon of biology. The purpose of this experiment is to find out the effect of ionic concentrations on the morphology of red blood cells. That is, we will be keeping them in hypertonic as well as hypotonic environment, and we will try to study the effect of this ionic concentration on their morphology. This experiment works on the principle of osmosis. That is, we will be keeping red blood cells in first the normal physiological environment, that is 0.9% saline. In this environment, the red blood cells will express their normal morphology. After this, we will be keeping these cells in the hypertonic environment, that is concentrated saline solution, because of which they will lose water and shrink in size. After this, we will be keeping these cells in hypotonic environment, that is 0.6% saline, and because of which they will increase in size, swell and burst. Now let's gather the material which we are going to need in this experiment. In this experiment, we are going to need saline solution. For this, I had prepared three saline solutions, that is 0.6% saline, which will work as a hypotonic environment, 0.9% saline, which will work as an isotonic environment, and 1.2% saline, which will work as a hypertonic environment. Apart from this, we are also going to need alcohol for disinfection. We are also going to need certain glass slides, few cover slips, dropper, forceps, a pricking needle, and a compound microscope to make observations. Now let's start performing this experiment. First, we will take three slides and we will arrange them. Now we will collect the blood sample. For this, first we will have to disinfect ourselves. For this, we will take a cotton ball and we will wet it with alcohol. Now wipe your fingers clean with alcohol. Alcohol is a germicidal and it will kill all the bacteria which can create infection. Now after this, take the pricking needle and puncture very carefully to your finger. Now place three drops on each slide. After placing the drops, put the cotton on the wound which was created by the pricking needle. Now discard this cotton, and after this, immediately add 0.6% saline to one slide. This will work as hypotonic environment. Add 0.9% saline to the next slide. This will work as isotonic environment. And add 1.2% saline to the last slide. This will work as hypertonic environment. Now mix this solution gently. and put a cover slip on each three slides. Now, allow it to stand for 2 minutes and observe them under the microscope. This is the compound microscope which we are going to use for our observation. Now, take the slide with isotonic environment and put it on the stage. Fix the slide using clips on the stage. Now, first adjust the field using the coarse screw. Once adjusted with the coarse screw, adjust the fine adjustment screw. Once you have adjusted the slide on low power, switch to high power. Now have an observation again. In the first part of the experiment, it was observed that RBCs were completely rounded and biconcave in shape. With progression of time, we see no observable changes in the morphology of RBC, suggesting that ionic concentration inside the RBC cytoplasm and the surrounding medium are same. However, in the second part of the experiment, it was observed that with progression of time, RBCs slowly tend to swell. This swelling is very slow but continuous, which is marked by change in their color. After some time, their plasma membrane is not able to accommodate the swelling and the red blood cells ultimately burst. In the last part of the experiment, it was observed that with progression of time, RBCs slowly shrink. Slowly they lose their shape and become crunched. This is also associated with change in their color as their color becomes more dark and their size is also reduced. Like all other cells, our red blood cells are also surrounded by a plasma membrane. This plasma membrane is a semi-permeable membrane that allows the diffusion of water molecule but prevents the diffusion of ions. Hence, whenever RBCs are kept in an environment that is different from their concentration, they tend to either gain water or lose water. Hence, in our experiment, when we had kept RBC in hypertonic environment, that is 1.2% saline solution, they tend to lose water. And because of that, they shrink in size and their color becomes darker. However, when we are keeping this red blood cells in hypotonic environment, that is 0.6% saline solution, they tend to gain water. And because of that, their volume increases, their color fades down, and ultimately they burst out. Hence, from this experiment, we had learned that normal physiological saline is 0.9%, and the osmotic concentration inside our red blood cells is 0.9%. Hence, those conditions like where the patient is suffering from a condition like diarrhea or water loss, the person is infused with 0.9% saline, which not only restores his water balance, but also maintains the osmotic concentration inside the patient's body.